In this video, we're going to install, configure, and test the PI JDBC driver. Let's begin by installing a few things. The first is the PI JDBC driver itself. So we'll go ahead and install PI JDBC 2017 R2 by right-clicking on the installation kit, which you could obtain from the tech support download site, and selecting Run as Administrator. Great, this is complete. In a previous video, we already installed PI OLDB Enterprise, which included Provider and Enterprise, as well as PI SQL Data Access Server 2016 R2. These are both required for PI JDBC driver to function correctly. Since we've already installed them, we'll skip over that. If you have not installed them already, you'll want to do that now. The next thing we'll want to do is install the Java runtime environment, which is required for PI JDBC functionality. We've obtained the JRE for Java 8, so I'm going to run as administrator. Great, the Java runtime environment was installed successfully. So now let's close out the install kit folder. PI JDBC is not able to be tested through PI SQL Commander, so the quickest way to test functionality for PI JDBC is to use gitsnap or getEASnap. These are some utilities built into the installation folder. So let's show them now. Let's go into JDBC, samples, and we see gitsnap and getEASnap. Gitsnap has a bin and a source folder. And in the source folder, we can open our Java file with Notepad. We see that there's some code here. We'll go over this in a little bit. The bin folder has the actual class file. So let's go ahead and open up a command prompt. And let's navigate to this folder. Let's first type the word Java, that way it knows it's a Java application. And then let's type in the name of the class. First, it prompts us for a data access server name, so we'll type that in. Again, this is using the same data flow as PI ODBC, where your PI JDBC connections are being passed to a PI SQL data access server, and that PI SQL data access server is using either provider or enterprise to connect to the PI system. This is gitsnap, which is hard-coded to be PI ODB provider and therefore a direct connection to a data archive. So let's type in the name of our PI data archive. Trusted connection, let's do yes. Protocol order, we'll do HTTPS. You don't need to generate any logs. Tag name pattern, we can do sinusoid. We hit enter, we see that the connection was made. Version information was passed back as well as the current value of sinusoid, which is 86. This means that the JDBC driver installed on this machine is able to use the PI SQL Data Access Server to access PI OLDB Provider to get information from the PI Data Archive successfully. Now let's do the same thing, but using AF data. So we'll walk it back two folders. And we'll enter getEASnap. For this example, we're going to query an AF server using PI OLDB Enterprise under the hood when it routes to the PI SQL Data Access Server. So let's again type in Java, since this is a Java class, and then type in getEASnap. Here we're going to type in the SQL Data Access Server name, which is this machine, as well as our AF server name. Let's use a trusted connection. Don't need any logs. Now for the catalog name. This is the database name for the AF database. So the best thing to use here is to open up PI System Explorer and just make sure that what we see in PI System Explorer with the AF SDK directly is what we see in the output of getEASnap. So let's change to our test database called database 1. We see the name of the element is test element, and the attributes here are test attribute 1 and 2 with values of 1 and 2. So our catalog name here would be database 1, and the AF element would be test element. We see the connection comes back with version information as well as the values of test attribute 1 and test attribute 2. This is a successful test of PI OLDB Enterprise on the back end of a PI JDBC connection. Let's go ahead and close this out, move on to the next set of tests. In this next test, we're going to use a program called DB Visualizer as a third-party application to test our JDBC connections. So let's start by going to the tech support website. And let's look at the knowledge base article that's written to show you how to use DB Visualizer. So click on My Support, search knowledge base, KB articles. Let's type in DB Visualizer and open up the KB. The first part is about how to download it. So go to this link and we'll download for the correct operating system. I've already downloaded the one that I need, so I'll go ahead and right-click and run as administrator. Great, installation's finished, so now let's run DB Visualizer. First, we're going to click cancel on this. Then let's go back to the KB and see that we should select Tools, Driver Manager, then select Driver, Create Driver. Now let's go back to the KB and see that our URL should be this for a PI OLDB provider query. So we'll copy it to the clipboard. And we'll paste it here. We'll rename this PI JDBC. And we'll browse for the driver file. The next step is to create a database connection. We'll close this. Create database connection. And we'll give this a name, something like PI Server. And we'll select PI JDBC from the driver JDBC. We'll keep database URL as the settings format. And here we'll paste in the database URL from before. But this time, we'll actually change the different names. So our PySQL data access server name is PyRCVR1. Data source name, also PySRV01. And finally, we'll type in username and password. We'll click connect. We see the connection messages at the bottom, and we also see the schema on the left. This is a sign of a successful connection. Last thing we're going to do is write a query. To do this, we'll go into File, New SQL Commander. Here, we'll make sure that PI server is selected in the database connection, and we'll type in one of our queries. And we'll hit execute. Here we see all the values and timestamps returned from the query. Finally, we can go into the PI server connection and specify the provider options such that we can give the default timestamp like we did before. So let's do that now. First, we'll disconnect. Then in here, we'll give another provider option. We'll save it and connect again. We see that it's successful, so let's go into our SQL commander and click execute. As you can see, now we only have 5 values and our time step is 6 hours each. This proves that we're still able to provide OLDB provider options from our JDBC connections, as well as we're able to use a third-party application to prove successful data flow and queries for PI JDBC. This concludes the video on installing, configuring, and testing the PI JDBC driver.